Welcome to Golden Spike. Glad you're here today. It's pretty warm and you're green. Too happy you're not standing up here in the dark corner. What are you here for? What'd you come? Watch the re-enactment? See the locomotive? I bid you welcome. We are met today to commemorate the completion of a project which is a remarkable example of the faith, determination, labor of thousands of men in a union which this very day will be consummated forever. We are assembled today to link the ends of the earth, to complete a new and a shorter route between Europe and the Orient, and to join the raw riches of the American West with the finished product of the Industrial East. We are also met with mixed emotions, with great joy that in a combined effort and common cause, the brains, muscle, and labor of thousands of men have joined together for the completion of this project under the guidance of Almighty God. However, it is with great sorrow that we remember and pay homage to the hundreds of men who gave their lives that you and I might stand here on this very sacred occasion, one with another. It is, however, noteworthy that the Pacific Railway was completed 6 years prior to the final locket for its construction. Among those in attendance today, we have many Roman officials who are not taking part in this ceremony. We also have many of our nation's famous newspaper, the reporters, and some photographers. We have from the 21st Infantry is here with their regimental commander, General Milton Cogswell. He will fulfill President Lincoln's dream of being able to reinforce a military garrison from the east coast to the west.
California, within whose borders and by whose citizens the Pacific Railroad was inaugurated, desires to express an appreciation of the vast enterprise by which her joint action is about to be consummated. From her mines of gold she has forged a spike. From her lords she has hewn a tie. And by the hands of her citizens, she offers these to become part of the great highway, which will unite her in closer fellowship with her sisters of the Atlantic. From her bosom will take the first soil. Let hers be the last tie and the last fight. Except within the hopes and the wishes that your greatest dream may not stop short of its brightest promise. This spike, a gift to Frank Marriott, publisher of the San Francisco Newsletter. Its inscription reads, "The San Francisco Newsletter offers its homage to the great enterprise that has spanned the continent this month, May 1866. 1979. In conclusion, I draw your attention to this spike. A gift of David Hughes of San Francisco. On its head is engraved the last spike. On three sides, the names of railroad officials, and on the fourth side, this sentence. May God continue the unity of our country as this railroad unites the two great oceans of the world.
Required and the weight to be transferred. In conclusion, I will add that we hope to do ultimately what is now impossible on Long Line. Transport cars, heavy, cheap products, all distances at living rates to the trade. I thank you.
Gentlemen, the great Senator Thomas Hart Benton proposed that someday a giant statue of Columbus should be built on the highest peak of the Rocky Mountains, pointing westward, denoting this as a great route to cross the continent. You have made that prophecy today a fact. This is the way to India!
Of the spikes with the mark.
Next year. Fantastic